Hey, what is going on, people? Dargrey here, bringing you another Yu-Gi-Oh! Video. This time, we are doing a combo tutorial for the Zephyr archetype. Here you can see a very standard OCG Zephyr list utilizing the turret type engine, but instead of target on board, we are running Marble Machine as well as the Red Eye Dice. The Marble Machine is a low scale that can help with the deck's pendulum strategy, while the red dice can be used with Terror Top to make a Yazi for your male shenanigans. This engine was recently popularized by a Japanese player and has proved to fit the deck really well. Now I'm actually not going to go further into explaining the list, because I believe by looking at the basic combos, you guys can better understand how the deck functions. So without further ado, let's jump right into the combo tutorial. Alright, so the first combo I'm showing you here is one of the basic 2-card combos. All you need is a search and also a way to dump Dark Room to a graveyard. Dark Room is the best starter for the deck. Not only does it search for you Gate Zero as a low scale, can also be used as a Link Father to turbo out Electromite. So you almost always want to have access to Dark Room. Now I'm gonna search for Gate Zero and use the Providence to get myself Zephyrus. Using Zephyrus effect to send Zephyrnia to the extra deck while changing itself to scale 7. Now I can go ahead and pendulum summon out the Zephyrnia, using its effect to get the Oracle, the fail spell. Now I got activate the Oracle to search for Zephyr Wendy. Then I'm gonna link summon Electromite, sending Chronograph Sorcerer to the extra deck. So I haven't normal summoned yet, I'll be normal summoning the Zephyr Wendy using her effect to add back the Chronium. And I will proceed to pop one of the skills to add the Chronograph to my hand. This will trigger Chronograph effect, special summon itself, along with the Zephyrnia from my hand. I also get one card from Electromite. Now I'm going to summon Beatrice. This will trigger the Oracle effect, allowing me to draw one card and then discard one card. Meanwhile, I will send Distrudo to graveyard with Beatrice effect. I'm going to use Distrudo effect to revive itself, and then link away Electromite and Distrudo for Neofiber. Neofiber will bring out the level 2 tuner, Mecha Phantom Beast Orion. It's a level 2 tuner, and I have a level 3 non tuner. I can synchro summon a level 5 Danlong. The Danlong effect to search for the counter trap card Night Pillars. Orion will give me a level 3 token, so now I have Danlong and a level 3 token means I can go for double A synchro summon. In this case, it will be a Rolo Savage Dragon. Both effect triggers. Danlong special summon now the Zephyrnia to the field. And Rolo Savage Dragon will equip the Electromite in the grave. So that's basically the result here. I have the Night Pillars. I also have one negate, Rolo Savage Dragon. The one negate, two negate, and I also have the Needle Fiber. Allows me to synchro summon during my opponent's main phase. So most likely, I will be synchro summoning Baxia, the brightness of the Yangxin. Because the card can bounce back one card on the field back to donor's deck. It's pretty powerful considering they're doing this during opponent's main. And also, if you are forced to use the Night Pillars before you synchro summon, you can use the Providence in your graveyard to prevent your Zephyrnia from being destroyed. So you can still go for group play. Even after of the nine pillars. Now, let's check out the second two kind of combos. This one is more advanced. It gives you another negate, but don't get to draw cards from Electromine. So at this point it's almost the same, but notice that I searched for Oracle with the Providence because later on I will be searching for Device Strike, the counter trap with my Zephyrnil. So it's better for me to just use the field spell early. So if you need to use your Zephyrnil to search for a monster, then you save one of the search spells for your Zephyrnil effect. But if you are going to use your Zephyrnil effect to search for the counter trap, then you just use up your both your spells early. Also in this specific combo, we're gonna use this field spell as a father. So very important for set up the spell early here. So actually I'm gonna search for the Phyrexy with the Oracle. I'm going to normal summon it and link to Electromite, using this fact to send Zephyrus to extra deck. And I'm going to use the back to pop the field spell, add back the Zephyrus. Now I'm going to send the Zephyrnil with the Zephyrus, and now I can finally pendulum summon. So I pendulum summon out Zephyrnil and also Zephyrexy from the extra deck. Both effects will trigger. Zephyrexy will make the Zephyrnil a tuner, and Zephyrnil will search for me Zephyr Device Strike as an additional negate. Now since the Zephyrnil has become a tuner, I can use it to link summon Needle Fiber. So the rest is pretty much the same. I'm going to make Dendo for 9 pillars. Then I'm going to make a Brolo Savage Dragon. Dendo will give me another monster. So this is basically the result here. So compared to the first combo, you don't get to draw cards with Electromite, you don't get to cycle one card with your Oracle, but you get one additional key, the Demise Strike. And also you didn't have to pay 4,000 life points for your Distrudo. So depends on the situation, you might want to go for this combo here for the additional negate. Now move on to three card combos. The first three card combos is the most classic, most standard Zephyrus three card combos, featuring the Zephyrus, a search, and a way to dump the Dark Room to a graveyard. So basically, the beginning is pretty much the same. And I set up the Oracle early because I'm not going to search for a monster later on. I'm going to use the Zephyrnil for the Device Strike, so I might as well just use up the field spell early. And I get myself the Zephyr Wendy. Now I'm gonna normal summon the Wendy to add back the Zephyrnil that was sent to extra deck with the Zephyrus. I'll link into Electromine, using the effect to send Zephyrexy to the extra deck. Now I'm going to pendulum summon everything. So I pendulum summon Zephyrexy and Wendy from the extra deck, and also Zephyrnil from my hand. Now both effects will trigger. Zephyrexy will make the Zephyrnil tuner. Zephyrnil will search for me Device Strike. Now I'm gonna link these two away into the Needle Fiber. Get myself the level 2 tuner. I'm going to make Dendo. So now What's interesting here is that we're actually going to use the Oracle effect here. Remember to put to have the Oracle effect training 1, then on effect training 2. This is very important. So this will allow me to select any monsters in my deck and put it on the top of my deck. So let's say I put the Ash Blossom on the top of my deck. So how do I get Ash Blossom? Easy, because I haven't used the Ultramite effect yet, so now I'm going to use the Ultramite effect to pop one of the scales. And then I can draw into the Ash Blossom I just put on the top of my deck. And the rest is pretty much the same. We're not going to make a Brolo Savage Dragon because there's no Link Monster in our graveyard. So instead we're making the Siphon Lore Omega. We're gonna get rid of one of the opponents who are in their hand anyway. And Denon will give us another monster. So that's pretty much your result here. You have a hand trap, any hand trap you want. You have two negates, you have Omega, and you have Needle Fiber that can be used to synchro plays during the opponent's turn. So this is the classic, most well-known 3-card combo for Zephyr. But there is another way you can do a 3-card combos. So this one is basically the advanced version of the first 2-card combo. The first 2-card combo, you use the Farnu to search for the Zephyr Wendy. But since now you have an additional search, you don't have to use the Farnu for the Wendy, so you can use the Farnu for your Divine Strike. Okay, so here again, I search for Zephyr Wendy. It's the Zephyr's effect to send Zephyr to extra deck. Now, instead of sending the Phyroxy, I'm sending the Chronograph in this case. Now, going to Pendulum Summon. D3. Use this effect to search for Y Strike. Now again, I'm going to use Electromite effect to pop one of the scales. Draw one card. Now I'm going to link Exit Summon Beatrice. Again, this is for this Judo. While the Oracle will trigger, I will draw one card. And you can discard the Dark Worm because it's not useful anymore. Now the rest is pretty much the same. Needle Fiber and go into Dendo. Finally, you go for the Savage Dragon. So this is the advanced version of the first 2-card combo. You end up with 2 negates, 3 negates, and also get to draw one card and cycle one card. Pretty nice, but it depends on the situation. Maybe you would want to do the first 3-card combo because you get to choose what hand trap you want to add your hand. So that is really really appealing. But sometimes you may want the Savage Dragon over the Siphon Lore Omega. So it depends on the situation. Now let's move on to the next one. This is also a 3-card combo. Future Wind, Search, a Foolish, and also a Tuner. So The idea here is basically that you already have a tuner, so you don't have to set up a tuner. Like you don't have to summon for Beatrice for a tuner. You don't have to use the Phyroxy to turn something into a tuner because you already have a tuner. This allows you to some different ways. Again, gonna send the Fernium. Go ahead, Pendulum Summon out the Tuner and also the Fernium. Gonna search for Divine Strike. Link into Electromite, use the effect to send several Windy to the extra deck. Pop one up skill, add back the for Windy. So, normal summon the Windy, add back the Zephyrnium, and you're gonna link the two away into Needle Fiber. And the rest is pretty much the same. You go for Danlong, search for Night Pillars, and you end up with the Savage Dragon. So 1 negate, 2 negate, 3 negate, and Needle Fiber. There's another way you can use this hand. Let's see. So this time, instead of searching for the counter trap, I'm going to search for the for Windy instead. So this means I will not have the Divine Strike, but instead I will have a chance to manipulate a card on top of my deck, and then I can draw into it with the Oracle effect. So again, add back the Zephyrnium, pop the scale to special summon Chronograph and Zephyrnium. Go into the fiber, make Danlong, and now again chain link one Oracle. So in this case, I put the Maxi on the top of my deck. So now before you synchro summon the Savage Dragon, you want to exit summon first, even though you don't need this troop though here. But this is to trigger the Oracle effect, so you can throw the Maxi and then discard one card. So that's the result here. Here you can also use the Beatrice to dump an additional Providence or this Judo for later usage. So basically, you exchange the Divine Strike for the Maxi. Depends on the situation, you might want to go for this one. This one also gives you a Beatrice that you can use down like I said, Providence or the Judo, whatever. Okay, we are not done yet. We still have two more combos. These two are going second combos. This is how you can utilize your mirror to kill your opponent. So the first one here, I'm gonna use Terror Top to search for the Red Eyes. This effect to change Terror Top to level 6 in order to make Yazzie. Now I use Yazzie effect to destroy the back row. This will allow me to special summon Mirror. This Mirror effect to generate triple tokens. Now I'm going to make Dendo and Needle Fiber. So Dendo special summoned the Zephyrnium, and Needle Fiber special summoned the Orion. Use these two to synchro summon the Baxia. Use its effect to send one card on your opponent's side of the field back to the deck. Okay, so this is still not enough to kill your opponent, but you can use the Baxia effect. Destroy one of your cards. Revive a level 4 lore monster from your graveyard. Now you can synchro summon another level 5 monster. In this case, we are going to special summon the high speed roid, Tambara, or whatever it's called. This guy single handedly can go more than 4,000 damage. Now go straight into battle phase. And this is more than 8,000 damage. But what if your opponent has a monster that you cannot deal with the Luxy effect? Let's see if that happens. So here again, I special summon Turtub. So the rare dice. Use both to make Yazzy, pop the back row, and unfortunately I pop the Waken the Dragon. So my opponent get to special summon Ultimate Falcon, or something similar like Brawler Dragon. All those boss monsters that are difficult to deal with. So what do I do now? So basically, can use Baxia to remove the Ultimate Falcon, so the answer is always the Bolo Sword. So here, again, you want to make Baxia with these two. You'll bounce back one card. And now, instead of destroy the level 1 token, you want to destroy something else. Revive your lion. For example, you can destroy a level 3 token. Now what we're gonna do is that you want to use the one token to link summon Link Weevil. So now you have access to Brawler's Sword. And that will be more than enough to kill your opponent. Okay, so that's basically for all the common combos. Again, hope you guys enjoy the video. If you like the video, you can give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more future content. This is Dark Ray. Have yourself a nice one. I will see you next time. Take care, boys. Of course, girls.